In the day's other news, the U.S. House of Representatives will not return to Washington next week as planned. Democratic leaders say the U.S. Capitol physician is warning that coronavirus risks are still too great. The House currently has 429 members with six vacancies. The Republican-controlled Senate, with 100 members, has been ordered back into session on Monday. In Lebanon, violent new protests have broken out in the city of Tripoli as the pandemic intensifies economic desperation. Rioting began overnight, with hundreds of people setting banks on fire and throwing stones at soldiers. This morning, crowds mourned a man killed during the riots, and later, more banks were set on fire.
What happened yesterday was because people are hungry and they're expressing their pain. And unfortunately, the government and the authorities are trying to suppress the people. When a bullet is fired, they accuse protesters of being terrorists. They do not want to hear the people and their pain.
Protests began last October across Lebanon over poverty and political corruption. Back in this country, the 2016 Democratic presidential nominee, Hillary Clinton, endorsed this year's presumptive nominee, Joe Biden. She is the latest party leader to take that step. Meanwhile, Ohio held its presidential primary today, mostly by mail-in balloting. It was delayed from March by the pandemic. The pandemic is also forcing a big change at the Oscars. Organizers announced today that movies that debut this year on a streaming service will be eligible for awards, even if they never screen in theaters. It is a one-year change only, forced by the closure of most theaters nationwide. A federal appeals court heard arguments today over a congressional subpoena for former White House counsel Don McGahn. House Democrats want his testimony on whether President Trump tried to impede the Russia investigation. The White House argues that the courts have no role in the dispute. And on Wall Street, stocks failed to keep a rally going today. The Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 32 points to close at 24,101. The Nasdaq fell 122 points, and the S&P 500 slipped 15. Still to come on the NewsHour, as Americans reel from the financial fallout, where has all the federal recovery money gone? The pandemic abroad, how New Zealand was able to bring COVID-19 under control. Keeping the faith, speaking with religious leaders during a time of shared fear. Plus, the conspiracy theories that have followed COVID-19 and what can be done to stop them.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.